Dear friends, greetings to all. Today's topic is classification of data. This is in the third chapter named classification and tabulation of the subject business statistics. Now let us study the meaning of classification. Classification is the process of arrangement of data into classes and to subclasses according to the common characteristics. Let us take one example. A researcher is going to study the socio-economic conditions of people in a locality. For that, the researcher collected data. In the data, one section is about the study related to savings habits, and for that the classification should be done on the basis of income, expenses, excess income, excess expenditure, and in the excess income, how much is saved. And hence the classification would be income, expenses, savings, excess expenditure, excess income. So that would be very clear for them. Now let us study the objectives of the classification. Objectives are of 5 types. First one is simple form of presentation of data. That classification help for simple form of presentation. The mass data is in complex and huge number. It would be in a simple form of presentation, classification done. Grouping has been done. Then second one is, it facilitates for comparison. In the classification, it is possible to know the performance of a business from one period to another. Then that savings of people from one period to another, whether increased or decreased. Like that, comparison can be possible. Then it helps for studying the relationship of the variables that can be easily understood. That means relationship means, for example, I am taking that impact of sales on advertisement. When more advertisement, whether more sales recorded. Like that, the researcher should note, and thereby that is possible to find out the relationship, whether there is any relationship between that advertisement sales. Okay, then fourth one is, it facilitates easy understanding. Facilitates for easy understanding. It's possible to perception and conception. It's possible. So when different sections are very well, classified, easy to get an idea. Then the last one is, fifth one, it forms the basis for the tabulation. When classification is done properly only, then the researcher can think of the tabulation. Okay. Then let us see the methods of classification. 4 types of classifications are there. One is geographical, another one is chronological, another one is qualitative, and fourth one is quantitative. Very easy to understand. That is geographical, then chronological, then qualitative and quantitative. Let us see what is geographical classification. The data are classified according to region, state, district, municipality, blocks, country wise. That classification is known as geographical classification. Then second one is chronological classification. The chronological classification is based on the time. It may be monthly or quarterly or half yearly or yearly, for 10 years, 15 years. Like that, data are classified means that is called chronological classification. Then third one is qualitative classification. This is the attributes, characters, behavior, data related to that aspect means we are calling it as qualitative data. This data can be classified into two types. One is twofold classification and another one is manifold classification. Twofold classification means only one character in two attributes, that is present or absent. The literacy level, say, is noted as degree, then research is going to the field and asking the respondents, they are telling that, oh, I studied a degree. Then, yes, I have not studied degree. Then, no, presence or absence. Then, in the manifold, more than two. That means, for example, education and employment. In the specified education, that education may be defined. It's a degree or postgraduate. And in that level, how much are employed, how much are not employed. Thereby, educated, non-educated, employed, unemployed. So, that is manifold classification. Then, quantitative classification. The phenomena which can be measured in quantitative terms is called quantitative phenomenon, and the data related to that and its classification is known as quantitative classification. Income, expenses, marks, savings, rainfall, etc. Then let us see what are the different types of classification. One is discrete series and continuous series. Discrete series means that variable may be 10, 15, 20, 30, 40, like that it may be. Or 10, 12, then 17, like that also. That may be the score of the intelligent test. And how many students are in that category, say 17 mark out of 20. And how many are 19 out of 20. How many are 15 out of 20. Like that, this classification is known as, that is discrete series of classification. Continuous series means based on class interval, that is 0 to 10, 10 to 20, 20 to 30. In a class, the marks may be from 0 to 100, then 0 to 10. That classification may be either 0 to 10 or 0 to 20, 20 to 40, 40 to 60, 60 to 80, 80 to 100. And how many recorded frequency will be there in the second column. Like that in the discrete series also, frequencies in the second column. That is the way of class interval classification. May need not be 0 to 10 like that, maybe 0 to 25 according to the nature of the phenomenon it would be. Okay, thank you very much.